This video training session will demonstrate an Eaton software tool called EIP Assist. The purpose of this tool is to make the integration of Eaton's motor control products into Ethernet IP systems that use Rockwell PLCs fast and user-friendly. You will see how easily this tool generates all I/O tags for Eaton motor control products and imports them into RS Logic's 5000 and aliases them to previously created generic I/O tags for these products. This eliminates the need to manually enter any I/O tag information into RS Logic's 5000 for Eaton products. I'll begin by creating a project in RS Logic's 5000. After opening the software, select New Project. Then give the project a name and note the controller type and revision. The controller type in this case is a Compact Logix L23E with an embedded Ethernet IP port, revision 20, and the name I give it is MCC1. Select OK to create the project. The EIP Assist software tool works with any revision of RS Logix 5000. But beginning with revision 20, Eaton EDS files can be installed into the software. I'll demonstrate the difference between using the generic Ethernet module and a product's EDS file by adding a C441 Motor Insight overload relay to the project using both methods. I will also demonstrate using a different data type by adding Eaton's new drive line, the PowerXL DG1, to the project. I will use the data synth or 8-bit bytes data type for the Motor Insight I/O data, and data int or 16-bit integers for the DG1 drive's I/O data. So let's get started by building an Ethernet IP network in our RS Logix 5000 project. Right-click on Ethernet, choose New Module, and now we need to find the generic Ethernet module in this list. Select the generic Ethernet module and then create. From this window, we need to provide a name for this particular device. I'm going to call this C441R_GEN to represent the generic Ethernet module. You must then choose your data type, data synth. Enter an IP address. I'll use a generic IP address. And for the C441 Motor Insight, I'm going to choose input assembly 110, which is 20 bytes in length, and output assembly 105, which is 1 byte in length. And you need to put something in for the configuration. I'll just enter a 1. And select OK. Now we'll keep the defaults from this second connection page using unicast messages and a 10 millisecond requested packet interval. Next, we want to add the C441 Motor Insight to the project using its EDS file. If I right-click on Ethernet again and select New Module and deselect all the vendors and only select the Eaton Electrical, if you just select Eaton Electrical, you'll see all the Eaton Electrical products by name. The one we want is the C441R-C441 Motor Insight. Select it, select Create. Now again, the name is very critical and must match what we're going to use for this device in the EIP Assist tool later. C441R_EDS, representing this device using its EDS file. I must give it an IP address, and then rather than having to enter all the I/O assembly numbers, look them up in the manual, and the lengths, I can select the change button, and under the name, the connection I choose, I can select the I/O assemblies I want to use. 105 output, 110 input, same as we did for the generic Ethernet module. Select OK. And OK again. And we've now added this device using its EDS file to the project. One last device we want to add and to represent the int data type is the PowerXL DG1 drive, which I'll select from the list using its EDS file. Select Create, and this we'll call DG1. Provide an IP address, and select the Change button. This will, and before we select the I/O assembly, we want to select the data type for this one because we're going to change it from SINT to INT. Then we'll select the I/O assembly. In this case, I'm going to use 23 for the output assembly and 73 for the input assembly. That's three input integers and three output integers. Select OK. And OK again. And now all the generic tags have been created. If we close this window, we go into controller tags area, and all the generic tags have been created for the C441R using the EDS file, the C441R using the generic Ethernet device, and the DG1 drive. So if we look at a couple of these tags, we'll see the input generic tags created, 20 bytes, for the C441R, for the output, the single output byte. And for the drive, DG1 drive, you'll see the three input integers and three output integers. So what we would need to do at this stage is for all of this data, we would need to open up the manual, take a look at what all the bit arrays, bytes, and words are, and add descriptions from the manual for all of this data. If you had a large motor control center with 20, 30, 40, or even 50 devices, that you would need to enter all this descriptive information or recreate all of these tags and alias them to the generic tags, it could take literally days to enter all that information. There's a better way, and that's the Eaton EIP Assist tool. If I double-click its icon and open up the EIP Assist I/O tag generation tool, the first thing you'll note is a list of all the Eaton motor control products that we previously saw in RS Logic's 5000. And the first question we're being asked is an EDS file being used? For the first device, remember, we used the generic Ethernet module, not an EDS file. So I'm going to select no. Then we remember it's the C441R, C441 Motor Insight. And when we select that device, the first thing that comes up is enter the number of devices. In most applications, where there are multiple of the same device, the same I/O assemblies are used. So if you selected a number greater than one here, it would then ask you if you want to use the same I/O assemblies for all of the same device type. And in most cases, you would say yes, and it would save time going through this tool because it would never ask you that again. In our case, we select one. Now I need to select the same I/O assembly pair that I selected using the tool, which was 105 for output and 110 for input. And now the tool only asks you this once. It wants to know where to store the CSV file that we're generating with this tool. So I'm going to put it in a demo folder I previously created. Next, it asks me for a file name. This could be anything, and I'll call it MCC1 to link it to the RS Logic's 5000 project, but anything would do here. Now we must enter the device name. Remember, I noted the device names in ArisLogic's 5000 were very critical, and in entering them into the EIP tool for each particular device, they must be identical, because that's what the tool uses to alias all the tags for each device in ArisLogic's 5000 to the generic tags. The first one we called C441R_GEN for the generic Ethernet module. I select OK. And now it added all those I/O tags to the CSV file. And the next thing it asks is, do you have more products? We'll say yes. Is an EDS file being used? Yes, for when we added the C441R the second time, we used its EDS file. So now we choose C441R again, quantity of one, the 105-110 I/O assembly pair as before, and now it asks for a device name for this one. The one we used in ArisLogic's was C441R_EDS. Select OK, and it now adds those tags to the CSV file. We do have one more device to configure, so we say yes. And we did use an EDS file for the PowerXL DG1 drive, so we say yes to that question. Select the PowerXL DG1. The quantity was one. And the output and input assemblies we used were 23 and 73. Now remember, we chose the int data format for the drive. So we'll say yes to this question that we did use COM format int. The device name we used in ArisLogic's 5000 for this device was DG1. And now we've entered all three products into this tool. So do we want to configure more products? We select no. Now it's showing us the path to where we chose to save the CSV file, and we select OK. Now the only thing remaining is to import that CSV file into our ArisLogic's 5000 project, so it can alias all those descriptive tags to the generic tags. If we go under the Tools drop-down menu, choose Import, Tags and Logic Comments, and now we go to the path where we stored the CSV file, select it, and import. So if you'll notice, we've imported 119 tags, 119 descriptions, with zero errors and zero warnings. Also note that all these descriptive tags for each device, C441R_GEN, C441R_EDS, and the DG1 drive, along with descriptions for each of these tags. The tag names and the descriptions exactly match what's in the manual for each of these parameters. If you select the Edit Tags tab, you can see the generic tags that each of these descriptive tags are aliased to. And finally, if we go into the main routine and add an input instruction, scan our tag database, and I'll choose device status input 1, which is the input state of input 1 from the C441 module. You'll see that a description is included, the descriptive tag name, and the generic tag it was aliased to. If we add an output instruction, I could decide that if input 1 turns on, I'll turn on relay output 1. And note, it's the description, relay output 1, the descriptive tag name, and below it, the output generic tag address as well that it's been aliased to. All the descriptive information has been included, for each of the tags, for each device, for each parameter. This tool allows you to use Eaton Mortar Control products in Ethernet IP applications with Rockwell PLCs with minimal effort, saving a lot of time. The EIP Assist tool can be downloaded from the Eaton website. That's eaton.com/software. And if you have any questions, please contact our support team free of charge at 877-ETN-CARE. That's 877-326-2273. Thank you.